Hello, dear student. I am Dr. Sachin R. Gengze, Professor and Head, Department of Electronics Engineering at Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. In today's session, I am going to present you with Introduction to Information Systems. The learning outcome of this session are, at the end of this video, after watching this video lecture, you will be able to define what is an information system and explain the typical process flow in an information system. As we know, we are living in the era of data and facts. So way back when the concept of data was not ever in existence, the Sherlock Holmes has said that data, 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 and I cannot make bricks without the clay. So he, the Sherlock Holmes, the famous detective, also felt the importance of data. In today's era, of course, the data has become very important and essential part of our life. So what is the data? As we know, all the modern organization, all the industry, all the institute, they create and store vast amount of data through different storage methods. But what is a data? So we have a very simple definition of data. Data is an elementary description of a thing or an event, activities and transaction that are recorded, classified and stored. But usually a raw data is not stored in an organized way. For example, when I go to a bank and open my saving bank account, then bank asks for a lot of data, like what is my name, my address, my PAN number, my Aadhaar number, or my photograph. All this is nothing but the description describing myself, and that is a data. Then I open a saving bank account and I do a banking, I do some different activities with the banking. For example, after some days, I may feel that there is a lot of money lying in my saving account and which I have to do as a fixed deposit. Then there will be a data generated. I am transferring some of my amount from my saving bank account into a fixed deposit. So there will be data generated according to that. So what is the amount, what kind of scheme I am adopting for how many years I am going to do this fixed deposit and all that. There can be transactions. For example, I am going to the bank, I am withdrawing some money. I'm putting some check, I'm using my ATM card, I'm using my credit card, I'm using my debit card, I may be using my Bheem app. All these are associated with my bank account. So there can be transaction. And every time I use my Bheem app, every time I use my credit card or a debit card, there will be a data generated. If I'm withdrawing money from the ATM, then there will be a huge data generated. From which ATM I'm withdrawing money, how much I'm withdrawing money, what is the date, what is the time? All this is associated with my bank account, and all this is a data. So this is just an example. So there can be number of types of data in today's world. Data, we may feel that the data is only numerical data. No doubt, the numerical data is one of the major data. For example, my bank account number is a numerical data. My IFSC code is a numerical data. Then the data can also be alphabets. My name, my address, these are alphabets. Image, the data can be image also. My photograph or my signature, which is scanned and stored, is also an image. There can be an audio data, there can be video data. Of course, the audio and video data may not be possible, at least in today's world with a bank account, but there can be different applications or different examples of audio data and video data. For example, we are using Facebook. So there are audio files and video files we can upload and we can download or we can use or we can see. All this is an example of data. And then these are the audios and videos. So all this is nothing but a data. How much is data is processed per day? As I said, we are living in an era of data. I remember my college days, somewhere in 1990s, I complete my graduation. And at that time, we are using a floppy disk of 360 KB. So you can imagine. So having a kilobytes of data was a luxury at that time. But now today we talk about the megabyte of data, gigabyte of data, terabyte of data, petabyte of data. Okay, so you can see that the petabyte is nothing but 10 raised to 15. So what is the typical data transaction, that is how much of data is processed every day? So as you can say, for example, the company like eBay, it is processing 100 petabyte of data. eBay is a very e-commerce company, very famous e-commerce company, and it is processing 100 petabyte of data per day. Google is almost doing 100 petabyte of data every day. Facebook is processing 600 terabyte of data every day. So you can see that these are just an example of some prominent companies, and vast amount of data is being processed every day. Now, why the companies need data? What is happening of this data? Now, as we have seen already, the data items is nothing but the elementary description of the thing, event, activities, and transaction that are recorded, classified, and stored is called as the data. And this data can be numerical, alphabets, images, audios, or videos. Now, when we are storing this data in an organized way, for which is easy for retrieval, then it is called as the database. Take an example of a class data. In a class, we have, suppose, 70 students. So there will be a lot of data that is being generated for this class, and then we are storing it. For example, there is going to be a roll number of the student, then his name, then his address, his gender, maybe his photograph, his marks for first year, his marks for second year, and so on. So all, if I want to store all this, what I can do is I can have a file in which I'll just put all this data together. Is it called as a database? No, because if I want to get some information, for example, I just want to know how many boys and how many girls are there in the class. If I'm storing all the data together in a single file or all the data together in any format, it will be difficult for me to get the answer. So what I have to do is I have to put that data in a tabular form. For example, the first column, the number of rows correspond to the number of students, and then there are going to be different columns. For example, the first column corresponds to serial number or roll number. The second column corresponds to the name of the student. The third column corresponds to his address. The fourth column corresponds to the gender. The fifth column may correspond to his first year mark. Now, this is called as the database. When I'm storing all this data atom in a very systematic way, then it is called as the database. For example, if I just want to know how many boys and how many girls are there in the class, I can just look at the column of the gender. I can just sort it out, and then I can find out how many boys and how many girls are there. Then if I want to know who is a topper in the class, I have to take just the mark of the last year, and just I have to arrange the mark, that column, into an ascending order. The top one will give me who is a topper of the class. So when I'm arranging the data in an organized way, then it is called the database. Now, what is the use of the database? The use of the database is that I can get a particular information or value out of this, and that is called as an information. As I say, I have a database of the class and I want to know who is a topper, the information I want, or I just want to find out how many students are staying at a hostel, then what I have to do is I have to just go through a particular column, and then what I get out of that is called as an information. So basically, we have data items. The data items stored in an organized way is called as a database. And from the database, I can retrieve the whatever I want or the important things that I want, and then that is called as an information. Usually, accepting the data, storing the data, then converting data into information, this is done, this is called the data processing, and this is done using an application. Now, in this context, the meaning of the word application is a computer software or a computer program. So the computer software or the programs are used for processing of the data. So here, I request you to pause the video and just give the answer of this question. What is the difference between a data, database, and information? And your answer should be back with a real life example. So I think you are now ready with an answer of what is the difference between data, database, and information. We'll move ahead and then we'll understand what is an information system. Information system is a system which collects, process, store, analyze, and disseminate information for a specific purpose. See, information system, the concept of information system was existing long back. See, today we have computerized banking system, but few years back, see, I remember when I was a kid, I used to go to a bank, and then there will be large books, ledgers were maintained, and people used to make an entries into this ledger. So does it mean that the information system was not existing before the computers? Yes, the information system was existing before the computer or the digital era. But in today's world, when we use the word information system, we are referring to a system which is a computer-based information system which is using computer or digital technology to perform some or all these tasks like collecting the data, processing the data, storing the data, analyzing the data, and disseminating information for a specific purpose. Now, this information system contain many small information subsystem specific to a particular application. And this information system, which I'm calling as information system component, are the small information system are connected through wired or wireless network. So this is a typical process flow of an information system. We have input which are being processed. Then there is a processing of the input using some programs, and then the outputs are generated. And in some of the cases, the human intervention may be there, or in some of the cases, this entire system is automated. So with that, we come to the end of the very basic session on introduction to the information system. The references we are using are, there are two good books on for this. The one is Information Technology and Management by Turbin and Volvino. This is a Wiley Student second edition, and the second book is Information System by Steyer, Reynolds, and again this is a Cengage Learning 10th edition. Thank you, student, for patient hearing.